Up on today's show, we have Sam Barboza with a story on an 11-year-old catching a crazy fish.
Finally, to close out the show, we have an episode of Entertainment with not Jackson Swile.
All that and more on today's episode of Flyer News.
Run fast for your mother, run fast for your father, run for your children, for your sisters and brothers. Leave all your loving alone behind. You can carry it with you if you want to survive. The dark days are over, the dark days are done. Can I ever rest? We are laying.
Good morning, Flyers. Today is day 6 with periods running DABEG.
Nick, do you like to fish?
I mean, I do, kind of, but I don't do really often.
What's the craziest thing you've caught?
Probably a turtle.
Well, an 11-year-old has a pretty crazy catch himself. Let's check it out.
An 11-year-old boy caught a fish with human-like teeth in an Oklahoma pond. Jana Clinton was sitting on her back porch watching her 11-year-old son, Charlie, fish in a pond behind their house in Oklahoma this past weekend when he suddenly started yelling for her. Jana got a close look at Charlie's catch, and it turned out that Charlie had landed a pacu, a fish that's a cousin of the prawn, and whose outsized teeth have long struck fear in swimmers. The pacu is a native of South America, but this one was swimming in a small pond in the Clinton suburb north of Oklahoma City. The Clintons posted a photo of the unusual fish to their neighborhood Facebook page and got in touch with a warden, but before learning of its provenance, they returned the pacu to the water. People who later recognized the fish said it was invasive and shouldn't be released. Since then, Charlie has been stalking the fish. He did stay at the ponds pretty late that night trying to catch it again, Jenna said, adding that her son has been rising early and staying at the pond late, hoping to get another bite from that pacu. If Charlie succeeds, Jana Clinton plans to get it mounted for him. Quote, I think that's a heck of a prize and he deserves it. Game wardens believe that the Paku was a pet that outgrew its tank and was released into the wild. Not only is this not the first Paku caught in Oklahoma, it's not the first time one's been hooked by an 11-year-old in the state. Charlie follows in the footsteps of Kennedy Smith of Lindsay, Oklahoma, who caught a Paku 5 years ago.
Shoppers at an Alaska grocery store witnessed an unusual scene when a bear cub wandered in to pursue the produce aisle. Alaska state troopers said a pair of wildlife troopers and Petersburg Police Department personnel responded to the trading union IGA in Petersburg on reports of a bear inside the store. Petersburg police body camera footage shows officers chasing the cub through the produce section. Officers were able to corner the cub in the shopping cart storage area and used a dog-catching pole to escort the browsing Bruin out of the store and into the back of the patrol vehicle.
21-year-old man missing in Massachusetts and Vermont State Police searching for of 21-year-old Massachusetts men who disappeared under suspicious circumstances. James Solomon of Pittsfield and Eric White of Chicopee were reported missing on October 15th after falling out of touch with their families for several days. State police said they'd previously been in Burlington, Lowell, Morrisville, and Stowe, officials said. Vermont State Police said investigators are concerned about the well-being of the pair. Searchers spent part of a rainy Saturday searching the area with around Albany and Lowell. A spokesperson on Sunday confirmed that Vermont State Police search and rescue team and New England K-9 participated in the search. The spokesperson declined to provide additional details, including why searchers focused on that area.
Christian, are you pumped for Halloween?
I'm pumped for Halloween.
What are you going to be?
I don't know yet. What about you?
No clue.
Well, you know what I do know?
What?
That we have the newest edition of entertainment with maybe Jax is Vile.
And welcome to the second episode of Entertainment. I'm Jackson Swile, and let's get right into it. Halloween is a little over a week away, so I wanted to discuss the most recent horror and thriller movies and TV shows that have come out, and some that I'm very much looking forward to. First, I wanted to talk about American Horror Story Delicate, also known as Season 12. In my personal opinion, American Horror Story has gone downhill since season 10, so I was not expecting that much. The season does have some returning actors, including Emma Roberts, Billy Lord, Dennis O'Hare, and Leslie Grossman. It did have some new people like Cara Delevingne, and, interestingly enough, Kim Kardashian. I think it's a solid season compared to the last season, but definitely not as good as the original seasons. Now I want to talk about a movie that I just finished about half an hour ago, Totally Killer. I had guessed that this movie was going to be a cliche teen horror movie, and I was absolutely right. I think it was a fun watch. I was definitely interested most of the time. I enjoyed a lot of the cast. I think that it's a really good concept. I was just not too surprised with everything. I think that it's a great watch for when you're kind of in the Halloween spirit and a little bored and like to multitask. Now I wanted to talk about the TV show The Curse, which airs November 10th. The show stars Nathan Fielder and Emma Stone, which is a duo that I would never have guessed would be in anything together, but now that I see them in the trailer, I completely understand. I love Nathan Fielder so much. Nathan For You is one of my favorite shows, and I watched the rehearsal over the summer and it was great. I also think Emma Stone is terrific, so I'm just so completely excited for this. I don't know much about it, I've only seen the trailer. Didn't really get a sense of what it's about, but I just know it made me extremely uneasy. For people who like unsettling mysteries, I think this is going to be a great TV show for you. Saving the best for last, I of course have to talk about Five Nights at Freddy's coming out October 27th. I have waited so long for this movie. Even before it was announced, I was wanting one. The cast looks great, the trailer looks great, it definitely feels on theme. I'm very excited for Matthew Lillard. I'm a big Scream and Scooby-Doo fan. The only thing I'm nervous about is that I haven't gotten tickets yet, so hopefully I see it before everybody spoils it for me. Have a happy Halloween to those who celebrate. It is certainly my favorite holiday. I'm Jackson Swile. Let's take it back to the desk.
That's everything for today's episode of Flyer News.
You can rewatch this and other broadcasts again on our YouTube channel or on the FEC TV tab on the school's website.
Make sure to check us out on Instagram and Facebook at Framingham High Studios.
Don't leave yet, because after this, we have the latest edition of The Early Bird hosted by Ben DeGroat and Zach Snyder. From Flyer News, I'm Christian Marshall.
And I'm Nick Swan. Have a magnanimous Monday, FHS.
Those Patriots, wow.
I know, they got the win. Zach, you know, it's a new week, and I got a new haircut. What are your thoughts? What are your thoughts, Zach? I don't know about it. I don't know how it looks on camera right now.
You were saying that with the product, it's pretty good.
I think it's all right with the product.
I got a recording of you saying that.
You do?
Yeah, in one of the stores.
You were recording me?
Yeah.
Really?
Yeah.
I didn't know that. Mm-hmm. So you recorded me without my consent?
Well, that's illegal, but no, I did not do that.
Well, you did, though, because I didn't know that you were recording me, so I couldn't have given you consent.
I think you're taking it a little too far. It's just a joke.
I don't know, Zach. I don't know about that.
Just like how the Patriots...
I won't press
Patriots
charges, Zach.
Patriots are still a joke
as well.
I decided
not to press charges, just so you know. I could sue you. But yeah, the Patriots got the win. Congratulations to them. I don't know, but I don't think this means a turnaround season, though. Because
No.
How can you lose by 30 to the Saints?
34.
34 to the Saints and make the playoffs. Just not going to happen.
Nope.
But we got a great episode today. We got a new segment that we are adding to the show. So first, we got to roll that intro.
Good morning, Flyers, and welcome back to the Early Bird. I'm Zach Schneider, and the guy with the fresh cut is Mr. Ben DeGroat.
How you doing, Zach?
I'm good. You know, this was a really short weekend, it feels like.
It was. You know what? I agree with that, actually. It was a short weekend. I feel like because we got used to the three-day weekends.
Yeah.
You know? And it's Monday again. Is this the first Monday in a while?
Well, no, we had Monday last week. But last week was a full week, but because the PM collab was
last week was a short week.
This week's going to be
rough. This week is going to be a long week.
Yeah.
But we have one PM collab on Wednesday.
No, we don't.
Are you sure?
No.
I could have sworn I saw it in the email.
I'm pretty sure the email that came out, the schedule was wrong.
Ah, okay.
Shout out.
All right.
Yeah.
Well, now we know. Now we know, Zach. But today's an exciting day.
Why?
It's the start of something. It's a new Monday, start of something new, new beginnings, Zach. Mm-hmm. All right? We are bringing out the wheel. So, Zach, today,
that's one really
we'll
nice
be
wheel.
Competing in a challenge to see who will have to spin this wheel. And the loser of the challenge will have to spin this wheel because this wheel is not a good wheel. And if you do not want to get this wheel, there are bad things on this wheel, bad things that you don't want to do. But first, we have to compete to see who's going to spin it, Zach.
So what are we going to be doing for today?
What are we going to be doing? I think
we have some pretzels with us, some small pretzels.
Some small pretzels. Are those from Trader Joe's, Zach?
They are from Trader Joe's, I think.
Pretzels from... Yeah. Those are really good, actually.
Yeah. I can smell it from here.
I can't eat too many of those or else I'll just get hooked. I could eat a whole
Should be the automatic loser.
No. I don't know about that one, Zach. I don't know about that one. I think we still got to compete.
What we're going to do, we're just going to throw best out of three so you can catch the most.
Who's throwing? I'm throwing. I don't really trust you to throw.
You don't trust me to throw?
I don't trust you to throw, so I think I'll throw it for
myself.
You'll
throw it to
yourself? I'll throw it for myself.
You start. You do yours
first. All right, we're going best of three.
Yes.
Should we go? I go,
yeah,
then you go?
Yeah.
All right.
Okay, here we go.
All right, I'll go first. All right, I gotta hope I don't hit the lights.
You missed.
But I'm pretty good at this usually.
No, you missed.
I might be blinded.
Okay, one.
Well,
okay. Did you get blinded or no? Okay, ready? Here we go. 1-1. It's dry.
It is very dry, Zach. Mm-hmm. But, you know, drier is a cinnamon challenge, and I don't want to be doing that.
Me either.
I'm hoping we don't get that on the wheel, because I've heard people die from that.
Mm-hmm.
So, yeah.
You missed.
Look, didn't even hit my teeth, Zach. Didn't even hit my teeth.
I didn't think you were that good at this. High key.
Yeah. I told you, Zach, I'm coming in here, and I don't want to spin the wheel. All right, so let's see it.
Here we go.
I'm 2-for-2, but are you? All right, we're both 2-for-2. Zach, I don't really want to go into overtime.
If we go into overtime, someone else is throwing it to us.
Yeah, definitely. We'll get someone else from the studio. But still, third throw.
Missed.
Perfect. It's too easy, Zach.
Let me find the smallest one. Found it.
Let's see.
All right, you're 3-for-3.
I'm 3-for-3. We'll see if you go 3-for-3, though.
The pressure's on.
All right, we're going to overtime. We need someone from the studio.
Christian Marshall, let's go.
Christian Marshall, he's a track athlete. He's a very fast hurdler. All right, he was anchoring today. Okay. I'm going to give you that.
From a distance?
From a distance.
Okay.
All right.
Give him a bad throw.
I want you to win, so like.
Thank you.
Missed it.
Light work. Let's go. All right. No, prison, you throw it up.
It's sudden death. So
I'll try and make it fair, though. I'll make it fair.
He's definitely going to throw it at my head.
I don't know, Jack. You give me a good...
Am I blocking the shot? Yeah, it's fine.
No, you're good.
All right.
I think we need a different thrower, and it's got to be from... Thank you very much, Christian. All right.
It's going to be on this side of the room.
We're going to have Mikey. Mikey is going to throw from all the way behind the camera. All right? Mikey, here's the pretzel. You're going to throw from behind the camera.
Okay.
Like right there.
Right here? Is this good?
Yeah, that's good. That works. All right. Ready?
3, 2, 1.
Ooh. Oh,
God. I had to swerve for that one.
That was good.
All right. Now.
God, for you.
Jack, this could be it.
Hey.
I mean, this is a tough one.
All right.
Tough distance. We'll see if you can get it.
It doesn't matter. Just start.
All right. 3, 2, 1.
Oh!
Oh,
yeah!
Yeah!
Thank you very much, Mikey.
No problem. Thank you very much.
So I will be spinning that, but before...
Before you spin the wheel...
We have the pledge.
Older than the trees, younger than...
I pledge allegiance to the flag of the United States of America and to the republic for which it stands, one nation, under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all.
Well, Zach, unfortunately, you lost the challenge, which means you have to take a spin of the wheel. And next Monday, you will be doing whatever that wheel tells you.
Right? We'll see what it is.
The wish is your command. Yeah, I'd say show the audience. Show the audience while you're spinning.
All right.
So everyone can see. But actually, we'll get it right here so we can get a nice close-up shot of it right here. All right.
You want to spin it? I can spin it. Let's not get the cinnamon challenge.
All right, let's see. Hopefully, we just don't get the cinnamon challenge. Hopefully, you don't get other guys' spins.
Eat a bug!
Next
week, that's not the worst Monday one.
You know, that's not the worst one. They got, like, chocolate-covered bugs or something. You could... It's not that bad, all right? There's definitely worse. You could have gotten the cinnamon challenge and died.
Yeah.
I think we'll be replacing that one for next week.
And then we'll also be replacing Eat a Bug after you eat a bug next week.
But first, we have the announcements.
Good morning, Flyers. Today is Monday, and that means the very first meeting of FHS Against Violence is today.
We will be doing introductions and talking about our goals for the year. We are an anti-violence club, so if that's interesting to you, come to C118 right after school.
Have a good one, FHS.
Thank you very much. You know, Ben, this is a great wheel.
Yeah.
All of these ideas are very good. We came up with these together, right?
Yeah, we did come up with these. They're terrible things that we don't want to do.
But we decided that we would do them.
We will do them in the name of entertainment so that everyone can be entertained. So we are consenting to these, whatever challenge we spin on here, we are consenting to do that. But Zach, next week, next Monday, we're going to have a bug here and you're going to have to eat it. So, I don't know, I'll order it off Amazon. Is there any bug you would prefer?
I'll order it.
Any bug you would prefer?
I'm going to order it.
Your bug of choice?
I'm going to order it.
What is your bug of choice?
I'm going to order it.
But tell me what bug you're going to get, though.
I'll figure it out. I have a week.
I want to know.
I have a week.
You have a week to decide. Yeah, it makes sense.
Is it next Monday?
Next Monday. We'll see. We'll see what
you tune in next Monday.
Yep. Next Monday, we will have the wheel yet again. He will be eating his bug. Then we will be competing again and spinning the wheel again to see who spins, who does the next challenge.
Yes.
All right, Zach. Great. Thank you very much for competing in this with me. It was a pleasure.
I think that was a little rigged, but anyways.
I don't know about that because I think it was pretty even.
Yeah.
Like this throw that Mikey gave me might have been good.
Yeah.
But anyways, it's great Monday. Start the week off right, Flyers.
Get
you
to
know.
D period.
It's A B C D E.
No, it's not. It's D A B. It's D A B E G.
It's G day six. My bad.
Get out of homeroom. Get to D period on time. I know I have a test. I don't know who else does. Get there on time. Get there early. Why, Ben?
Because the early bird gets the worm.